I'm Ruth Badger, and in business, I've got the golden touch. You may have seen me on TV before, but this time, I'm in charge. I've got 13 years business experience. In 2 years, I helped a company increase their turnover from 3.1 million to 13.1. That's 10 million in 2 years. Struggling businesses, no matter how big or small, I'll make it my business to turn you around. So if your company's on its knees, I'm the person to call. Bring on the Badger.
This week, it's going to be curtains for this business unless I can make this overbearing boss see sense.
What you're not doing, and I could physically shake you, is you do not listen to anybody.
So what's the next step?
To rip Ruth's head off.
This week, the Badger's back in her hometown of Wolverhampton, where a family-run curtain and blind company is desperate for help.
This is where I started my business career, so it's really nice to be back home, to be helping a company from Wolverhampton who is really struggling. To get them back on their feet means the world to me.
Tina Noon started Camberley Curtains 7 years ago and now employs five staff, including husband Kevin and daughter Marie.
Been making curtains for 25 years and it's absolutely in my blood.
18 months ago, ignoring her family's advice, Tina decided to leave their two high street shops and move swag, tail and pelmet to this 3,000 square foot industrial unit.
It was my choice to buy the unit. I spotted it, thought it was a good buy. Dragged four or five people with me, kicking and screaming.
To move wholesale and shut the shops, I thought that was a wrong move.
Mum's definitely the boss when it comes to making decisions.
But this decision has caused their turnover to plummet by 25%.
We thought that it would work, but I think we've shot ourselves in the foot by losing the two frontages.
Tina's plan was to bring in high-volume trade contracts, but she hasn't picked up a single one since the move.
I have pushed it to this level. I know where I need to get. How the hell do you get there?
The Badger has just 7 days to get Camberley off its knees. Her first challenge is finding their new premises.
This is actually quite far out of the town centre. I mean, you wouldn't walk it. Oh, there it is. Look at it. You wouldn't even look at the signs and think that was it. There's nothing around it that would make you actually think, oh, I'll go there, because I'll look at that shop and that shop. This is proper back streets, isn't it? I need to go and find out what's going on. I know a girl with a golden touch. She's got enough, she's got too much. But I know you wouldn't mind. Hello, hello.
Hiya.
Hello, pleased to meet you. I'm Ruth Badger.
Marie.
And what part do you play in the company, Marie?
I make all the curtains, I serve the customers. Basically a bit of an everything at the moment.
Okie doke, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm going to grab this gentleman who's walking away from me. Pleased to meet you, I'm Ruth Badger.
Hi, Kevin.
Kevin, and what do you do in the company, Kevin?
I'm a company director, I'm afraid.
Afraid?
So, yeah, I do everything.
Right, jack of all trades.
Yeah, I do everything in the business, so.
It's quiet, isn't it? What's upstairs?
Showroom, big showroom.
Is that where the boss is?
That's where the boss is, yeah. The main one.
Okay, see you later. Yeah. I saw my girl with the golden
touch. Hiya, Ruth.
Hello,
how are you doing?
Hello. How are you?
Yeah, not too
bad. All right?
Yep.
Pleased to meet you.
Yes, and you. I'm glad you've come.
I thought you sold curtains and...
No, a little bit more than that.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah, do you like it?
It's like a wonderland. I get lost in it.
Have a walk through. We've got sort of wallpapers, we've got chaise lounges, curtains, blinds. What do you think?
You've got a lot of stuff in a small space, haven't you?
And the chintz goes on.
People were asking, have you got a lamp? Do you know where I can get a lamp? So we've just sort of bought them in. Pop them sort of on the ceilings. We've just put them out, see what happens there.
Tina's business strategy is about to be unstitched by the Badger.
Right, Tina, why leave two shops for a factory unit in an industrial area?
Thought it was a good idea at the time.
Why?
Cheaper costs.
How many people do you get into your showroom a day?
Probably three. We've no passing trade here.
Cost worth paying?
If with hindsight, no. Kevin was screaming, we still need a shop, we still need a shop.
So Kevin's told you that?
Yes, he did, loud and clear.
And you didn't listen to him?
No.
Why?
Tina's Tina. Tina knows best. The idea as well was to get contract work. We've sort of contacted double glazing companies, golf courses, hotels, show homes. Got a gazebo company that we're chasing.
So you've got a hell of a lot going on at the moment.
Really, really trying to push it forward and hitting one hell of a brick wall. Why? I don't understand.
Are you tired?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know your brick wall?
Uh-huh.
I'm going to take a sledgehammer and I'm going to knock it down.
That would be great.
Tina is really passionate and, you know, full respect to the woman. She ain't giving up. She's trying to think of all these new radical ways to move it forward. And the worst thing is, she's missing the bloody obvious. She's watering the business down instead of actually focusing on what she does and where she's based.
Day two. And to check out Camberley's overworked MD, Ruth observes a typical morning for Tina. She's the engine of the business, being the only one to make site visits to sell curtains.
Hello, Mrs. Travis.
While also trying to manage the company as a whole.
Pleased to meet you too.
The Badger first tests her ability as a saleswoman.
Let's get them all out. I love this. It's going to look really nice, especially with those sort of muted colours. And I think it's going to look absolutely smashing next to your wall.
Actually, it's got the right kind of colour for the pink. I wouldn't have picked that if you hadn't said in the shop.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we'll decision made?
Yes,
right,
decision
OK.
Made. Easy peasy.
Now, all I need to know from you is how we're going to have the curtains. Pinch pleat, we can have goblet.
Which would you recommend then?
Definitely pinch. Right. Definitely. This is lovely. I just think it's too fussy for you.
Yes.
I know your style and I just think it's just enough. You can
Tina can sell. You know, I was well impressed. She's literally leading the customer. No, you don't want that material, you want this material.
And we could do you a throw, could make you a nice throw.
It's really refreshing, she's very upbeat, very in control. If she walked into my house, I would buy without a doubt from her.
Given the opportunity, Tina appears to have no problem selling. But she can't be in all places at all times. Ruth heads back to the unit to see who else is made of the right stuff. First to be grilled is Tina's daughter, Marie.
Hello.
Hiya.
Busy working away?
I am, yes.
Right, the favourite word in my dictionary is selling.
Yes.
Can you sell?
Yes.
You can sell?
Yes, I can sell.
Oh, that's dangerous because the moment somebody says yes, I go prove it. Do you actually go out like your mum does and selling?
No.
So you do in the actual showroom, but
yes.
You don't go to people's
yes.
homes? Why not?
I can't quilt. I could sell till the cow come home.
So you can sell, but you can't close?
Mm-hmm.
Is that because you physically can't do it or your mum won't let you?
She lingers in the background while I'm trying to serve, so they automatically see her and start talking to her while I'm trying to serve them, and I'll give up in the end and say, I'll leave you with Tina and walk away, which hurts me because I've got so far with them and I'm nearly there and she'll come in and...
And how does that affect your confidence?
It did quite a lot when she first did it. It was like, well, I can't finish anything because she won't let me. And we did talk about it. She said she wouldn't do it, but she's...
Tina's husband, Kevin, sticks to measuring up and manufacturing. And fitter Pete doesn't get involved in sales at all. So it just remains to be seen if machinist Kerry is part of the sales force.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Who's the sewing there? I must admit, every time I've walked in here, I've always seen you sat here at your sewing machine,
Yeah, this is where I like to be. Yeah, I just like to be just manufacturing, making things.
Do you sell?
No, not particularly. I prefer not to, but I can do it.
Tell me when you think you can sell and when you really struggle.
I think if the customer's confident with what they want, then I'm more confident.
If I walked in and said, I have no idea what I want, can you help me?
Then the alarm bell start ringing.
Despite their nerves, Kerry and Marie are at the front line of showroom sales when Tina's out. Ruth secretly observes how they do. And when the boss returns, there's some revealing footage to confront her with.
You need to see exactly how your staff deal with people when you walk away. You ready to watch this?
I'm ready, yeah.
OK.
First up is Marie.
All your fabrics are there. If you're looking for blinds, all your blinds are over there and the books are all labelled.
Right, OK. All right. All right, then we'll be in a minute.
Excellent.
You think that's excellent?
Yes.
You've got blinkers on because that's your daughter. We don't know what they want. Right. We don't know what the colour scheme is. We don't know what the budget is. We don't actually know whether they're interested in buying today. We've asked no questions.
Yep.
So take them blinkers off, right? I know it's hard.
It is hard, yeah.
You know, but see it as you're the owner of the business.
Okay, yeah.
Come out and measure for you, and their quote will stay with us for about 4 months. Mm-hmm. So you've got plenty of time to choose.
We don't want plenty of time, we want sales.
Will Kerry have done any better?
Actually,
this
sort of
is
the current wall, that sort.
I'm just going to stop that there. When you're selling, you know, I'm going to face my body towards you. Uh-huh. If I'm literally talking to you and I'm going to talk like this, you're not actually going to get exactly what I'm talking about. That's silence. I mean, she's over there. I can't see any rapport being built, which is the worrying thing. Well, I wouldn't still be in there.
No. If I'd have been in that room with Kerry, I would have moved Kerry over and I would have done it myself.
You've got a very unique business because every single person tries to give as much as they can.
They do.
That is very unique. Mm-hmm. The problem is...
Yeah. It's not come together.
It's you.
Ah, why?
Because in that situation, if you stood back and watched her, instead of jumping in, you'd have noticed this before.
I'm too busy jumping in. I'm too busy jumping in to realise. Okay, I need to take my blinkers off.
If Ruth's going to bring big contracts to this company, Tina will have to spend even more time with clients. And this means that Marie and Kerry will have to shape up on sales.
Today, I actually saw how each individual sells in the company. Or should I say, how one individual can actually sell in the company. When Tina's in there, Mummy's at home, everything's fine. When she walks out, big problems. I need to solve that as quickly as I can.
Coming up...
Right.
The badger gets her claws into the boss.
What the bloody hell are you doing? You're a control freak.
But Tina bites back.
I've took back the reins. My business, my reins.
Camberley Curtains is in trouble. With only 3 customers a day coming through the doors since their move to this industrial estate, turnover has collapsed. MD Tina Noon hasn't managed to bring in the big trade contracts the company needs to survive long term. She's been too busy micromanaging her staff. Sales whiz Ruth Badger is used to bringing businesses back from the brink. It's her 3rd day at Camberley, and she has a plan of action to turn things around.
Hello. Right, now comes the time that the observation from me actually stops and the hard work starts. Sales. Well, normally I'd talk about the sales staff, but realistically in this business, it's one woman, you, Tina. Well, the one woman crusade, Tina, stops now.
Okay.
You're a control freak, and in a way, you're stifling the business. You two have got to actually start realising exactly what your role is in the business. Mm-hmm. And it's not just making curtains, it's actually doing everything for the business that you physically can. So this is your wake-up call. And believe me, it starts now. The showroom. Do you know those tat shops? A pound for anything. You walk in and it's full of crap and you have to go around and you have to have a look. I'm telling you, the moment you walk into your showroom, I see dining tables, I see sets of this, sets of that, sets of this. What the bloody hell are you doing selling jewellery in a curtain shop?
You've got a lady that comes through the door that wants a pair of curtains. As she leaves, she spies the jewellery. If I can sell her a £5 thing on her way out, why not get it?
Do you know what? Absolutely not. What you're actually doing is you're watering yourself down instead of focusing time and effort in your products. You need to simplify your showroom. Stick to what you know. Let's talk about the most important thing for me, which is your profile and your marketing, and how we're going to bring more business in here so you're all busier. At 4:30 today, Tina, I'm going to take you to a meeting where you're going to go and see a group of interior designers who supply the biggest house builders in the country. That's who they supply to. You could become one of their curtain manufacturers for them.
Excellent.
OK?
Sounds brilliant.
I'm giving you the best opportunities, so we need to work at it. But now the fun begins. Let's talk about local delicacies, about faggots and peas.
Oh.
Today, I'm going to take you to Bilston Market.
Lovely.
And we're going to get you selling faggots and peas at lunchtime in Bilston. Selling is selling. Yeah. Whether I've got an apple, whether I've got a pear, whether I've got curtains, whether I've got faggots, peas and gravy, I can sell and I love it. You can do it, Kerry. It's no good shaking your head. But I want 110% commitment.
You've got it.
Are you all going to give it then?
Yeah. Everything Ruth is saying is right. I mean, we do all need to, you know, book our ideas up and learn.
The Badger's first task is to get Marie and Kerry confidence selling. So it's off to market for the ladies.
The moment we start, I'll shout faggots and peas for a pound and I will stand here and I'll give them to you. Kerry out there selling, talking to people.
No problem. No problem.
Faggots and peas for a pound!
Make as much noise as you can, Marie.
Yes,
I'm listening. Tina can't help proving she's still in charge.
Yes, boss.
Faggots and peas!
But she might have got the message about getting off the girls' backs.
Faggots and peas!
Left to her own devices, Kerry gets off to a flying start.
Can I interest you in some faggots and peas for a pound? I need the sale.
Faggots and peas, two for a pound.
You ain't going to sell stuff in there. Go and get them. Go on. Faggots and peas for a pound. If you don't want it for your lunch, you can.
And after a little more badgering, Marie gets in there as well.
Faggots and peas,
you can have some faggots and peas.
Warm or cold, take a take away. Cold. £2, please. Thank you. It's two for this lady room.
Shy seamstress Kerry has found an appetite for selling, and the Camberley coffers are filling fast.
I've lost count how many I've sold, but it's
who
good
wants
fun.
Do you want gravy on these?
There you go.
I'll just have a drop of gravy.
Yep.
We need some more peas.
And molly-coddled Marie has begun to come out of her mum's shadow.
Marie, how are you getting on? How many of you sold it? Five people. Yeah. Do you see how easy it is to go there and start building the rapport? And most importantly, asking them if they want the product.
Yes.
Yes? Never going to sell curtains unless you ask people. Faggots and peas for a pound. Who's going to take the last few off our hands? There you go. Three faggots. Who has just sold the last faggots of the day?
Me.
There you go. Pleasure to do business with you. The faggot and pea store is now closed.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Don't you?
Did you have to make every sale yourself? Can you sell?
Yes.
Yay! Well, then I think that was a result. Yeah. Well done. Yay. I am really chuffed with you.
It's day four for the Badger and D-Day for Tina. For the last 18 months, she's failed to get anywhere with companies that could provide contract work. Now Ruth has set up a meeting with one of the UK's biggest interior design companies, Inside Right. But will Tina be up to the challenge?
Are you nervous?
I'm okay. Right. I expect
Relax.
It to be.
Yeah. Let's enjoy it. I've never been in a company like this before. Right, shall we go up?
Hiya.
Hello.
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 Hi.
Becoming a curtain supplier for this company alone could secure Camberley's future.
Chantal, nice to meet you.
Firstly, thank you very, very much for seeing us today. I want to sort of sort out a relationship that was made in heaven, where you back a local business through expansion, and also your customers benefit because Tina does a quality product.
What sort of capacity do you have at the moment? How many people do you have working for you?
We have 6 people at the moment, so we've been prepared for this for probably 18 months. Getting the unit sort of ready, functioning correctly before we contacted somebody like yourself.
Do you have anything to show us?
I've got a laptop with some pictures on there.
Yeah.
Are these all recent installations?
Yes, they're probably 12 months.
What do you think?
To be honest, I'd like to come down and have a look at your outfit. Images here are great,
yeah.
But to actually look at the, you know, how you mitre your corners, look at the product and how you make it, and take it from there. And obviously, at the same time, we could discuss pricing. Give us a call tomorrow, and we can discuss it anyway.
That'd be smashing.
Great.
Thank you so
okay.
Much. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Cheers.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Nice to meet you, Tina.
Yes, Andrew. Thank you.
She's got over the first hurdle. Could things be about to change for Tina?
Bless you. Pleased?
Ecstatic.
The questions Geoffrey was asking you, he was testing you and you were spot on.
Okay.
Right, I think you should go home and have a glass of wine and celebrate.
2 glasses of wine.
Right, come on then, well done.
Cheers, girl.
It's the final day of the Badger's first week in the business and she has a last task for the whole team. Ruth has booked them a pitch in one of the biggest shopping centres in the Midlands. They'll be taking their wares to market instead of waiting for customers to find them.
Today for me is not about selling and closing.
It's
today
about
is about
them.
Booking. Let's get them in the diary, so you definitely need to bring your diary with you,
right.
And let's get that interest there. Because what you can do, and this is about utilising time in here, when the people aren't walking through the door, is all the people that you actually see face-to-face today, you call next week, you call the week after.
Yeah.
If you go there and you get 15 leads, then is it worth the expense? Well, we don't know, because we haven't run it through the books.
Yeah, we can follow the leads on and see where whether it's actually worthy.
Okey-doke.
Yeah, smashing. Let's do it.
But before they can be unleashed on thousands of shoppers, Kerry and Marie need to learn to sell Badger style.
I'm going to point out the simple facts of selling. First of all, Marie, you know when you see somebody walking their dog, and you see them walking and the dog's there and they're walking in front, and then you see that person who's chasing their dog like that, trying to get hold of him. Me selling is me with a dog like that. You selling is you've got this big brute of a Rottweiler and you're holding on like this going, I'm so young, I can't hold on to it. Right, stop. Remember, the customer is there to be led, okay? So when it comes to the fact of asking questions, it's you that asks, it's you that leads. Right, come here. Right, simple. Now, what you need to do, stand beside me. So the first thing you do the moment you walk through the door is you greet them and you start to build rapport. Now, you've got no problem to do that. The next question you ask them is what?
Do they want curtains or blinds?
Do you want curtains or blinds? Not, can I help you? You lead them by the hand and you take them to an example. If you are actually looking for modern fabric, just have a feel of how does that feel? Is that what you're looking for? Get them to touch it, get them to feel it. Remember that bloody Rottweiler running off on that lead? That can't be you anymore. You want control, but go in with a rapport, break it down, build the rapport, qualification, the hook, and then the close. Next! Stand there. Right. What's this called?
This is a stand.
This is a barrier. Take the word sales and throw it out the window. Okay? Because when it comes to a mental block and putting a barrier up, that's what you do when people say the word sales. Right?
Okay.
Are you a saleswoman? No, you're not, but you have the potential to sell. Stand here, stand here, stand here. No barriers. Right.
Okay.
Never have your head buried over there when your customer's standing over here. Your weakness is the way you stand. Look at you. It's the way you're standing. Bless you. You ask the right questions. You are very, very knowledgeable about your product. With you, I want to see that human touch.
Okay.
You've got it in you. I know you have. I just want to see it come out.
It is.
Transported from the back streets to the heart of the city, the new improved Camberley sales force are about to put their training into practice.
This looks better than the outside of your shop. And do you know the best thing is?
I know.
All these people walking.
With almost 30,000 shoppers at their fingertips, compared to the 3 customers a day they get at the unit, they should be able to generate some solid leads.
You have got 3 seconds to stop somebody and engage them. I'll give you an example. Excuse me, can I just have 3 minutes of your time now? Stand looking at me. It's no good me getting you from here or getting you from here. I've literally got to be able to stop you and go, can I have 3 seconds of your time? Walk them over. You know when I talked about leading the sale? Stop people, walk them over. What I'm not looking for today is orders. What I'm looking for is leads. Have you heard about us? If not, give them a leaflet. Make sure you've got your leaflets, make sure you've got your pens and you've got your pads. Most importantly, name, addresses, contact numbers. If they are looking for curtains, you've got your diary, book them in.
Come on, guys, it just won't take a minute.
We're a curtain and blind company based in Willenhall. I don't know if you want to come and have a look. This over here, just a few of the things that we do.
Kerry remembers Ruth's advice to make eye contact with the customers and immediately gets results. Marie's improving too. She's leading the customer and asking all the right questions.
What colours are you looking for?
Well, my carpet's terracotta and my wall's cream, so it's...
So you'd go for something
in the middle of there,
right, yeah.
Okay.
How are you getting on?
Wonderfully. I've actually made an appointment for Tina to go out to measure a bungalow.
You're joking.
No, I'm not.
So you've actually got a lead fully booked in?
Yeah. I thought I'd get a few names and addresses, but I never thought I'd get an appointment.
Well, I'm really proud of you. The problem is, when you've got one, I want two, so you're going to have to carry on.
You would. You want blood.
Well, go on, I do, definitely.
With Kerry and Marie continuing to bring in leads on their own, Ruth wants Tina to take a step back and think about the future for her business.
Have a look through the window. It's a big space, isn't it? In 5 years' time, I want to see you in a place like this. You need to start working on the business and not necessarily in the business every day so it relies on you. So in 5 years' time, you should have a goal to be in a place like this and then to open satellite branches all around the Midlands.
I think satellite branching here, I could cope with mentally, monetary,
or in 5 years' time?
No.
Stop. Well, we're not talking now. Because my advice to you is what you're doing there. Get your contracts in and start learning from that experience and then put that into practice with an experience like this.
So, 5 years' time,
get
a
plan
for that. Okay.
Food for thought. I'll leave you to have a look at it without me.
Cheers, mate.
A few hours canvassing has brought in 16 names and addresses and 6 actual appointments for Camberley. Ruth's week with the company has come to an end. Time for a final pep talk.
If I said to you this time last week that you'd have been stood selling in the middle of Wolverhampton Wolford Centre, would you believe me?
No.
Would you believe that you could sell faggots and peas like they've gone out of fashion?
No.
No. Would you believe that you've nearly closed a deal with one of the biggest interior design companies in the country? No. It just shows you what is capable in a week. The most important thing is, to the one-woman crusade, this is not a one-woman business. Kerry, you can sell. You know you can sell. I don't want to hear any more of the, I can't sell, I can't do this. You've acknowledged you can. And madam, remember the dog. The dog on the lead. I'm going to go now and I'm going to be back in a week. Whatever you do, don't let me down.
We will.
Because Badger bites back when she comes back if you do. What I want to happen while I'm away is for the team to stop as they are in there now. So for Tina to be a fundamental part, but not the be-all and end-all. Marie understands where she's got to improve, and Kerry is on fire. What I think will happen is the fact that the moment I walk out the door, Tina's Tina, isn't she? She'll go back to controlling the manor, and everything will go back to normal. And realistically, I'll have to come back and fight my way back in there and open her eyes again. But believe me, I will do that.
It's Camberley's first day of their week without Ruth. The Badgers laid down the law. Tina has to step back and let her girls sell if the company's to grow.
Something a bit different.
OK, right, do you want to come with me? Yeah.
Marie's practising leading the sale.
If you can just give me some idea what colours.
Yeah.
just so I've got an idea of what she can bring out with her.
And Kerry's putting no obstacles between her and the customer. It's altogether a more touchy-feely experience for the client.
Feel your texture on that. It's thick, it's lovely.
That's your appointment.
Lovely.
I'll come and do a second.
Brilliant. And they're managing to sell without Tina.
Okay. Right, thanks so much.
But accustomed to absolute power, the boss is struggling with the badger's changes.
A bit upset at the minute, to say the least. I need direction. She's took my roadmap away from me. Either give it me back or leave me alone so I can get on with it.
Midweek, and the girl's second task is to declutter the showroom.
We're trying to change it so that it's more appealing to the customer, so when they come in, they've got more chance of finding what they want. Hopefully.
We will. We'll make it superb.
But they've hardly got started before control freak Tina pokes her nose in.
I'm trying not to enforce my opinions. I am really trying.
Do you think that table looks all right or not?
I think that we're blanking there off. Move that slightly in, slightly that way, so it's nearer to the blinds. If we move that, that won't match that. So that's staying. Two smaller stands there then, this one and that one. And move that one out for a minute, yeah?
Basically, she's the boss today, and if you don't do, then you get told off. It's the mommy that I don't like.
Things have changed for me mentally. I've took back the reins. I handed them to Ruth for a bit, but now it's my business, my reins. Pull this that way and that way. Just ever so slightly. Just a bit more. OK, that's it. Perfect.
By the end of the week, despite thinking she could go back to doing it all herself, Tina's feeling the strain.
I'm stressed. I'm tired. I've not slept for probably four nights. We've got to manufacture curtains. I've got to get fitters out there. I've got to do banking. I've got to do my work. I can't do it. The cracks are appearing. I need help.
The family tries to get through to her.
The whole umbrella of Camberley curtains is what I deal with on a day-to-day basis, plus my customer.
That's what Ruth said.
OK, Ruth said this. How do you get it off and from off my shoulders for you to have a bit, you to have a bit, and you're not stressed, and you're not stressed?
I am stressed. We handle it better than you do.
Give me something else. Give Kerry something else.
This is what Ruth keeps saying to you.
You've got to pass it. If I pass it to them, who makes the curtains?
Mum, we've got one.
You've got to do it this way and delegate, and the work suffers a bit to get you more money at the end of the day.
If anything I can do, pass it to me and I'll do it, you know I will.
Coming up, it all kicks off when the badger gets back.
What you're not doing, and I could physically shake you, you do not listen to anybody.
So what's the next step?
To rip Ruth's head off.
the last 18 months, Camberley Curtains has been bleeding funds. They failed to win the essential trade contracts to turn their slump in turnover around. Sales whiz Ruth Badger has been battling to get them deals with big companies and to get the control freak boss to change her ways. But when Ruth left them alone for a week, Tina just couldn't delegate and things went to pot. Now the Badger's back and she's only got 2 days left to bash the business into shape.
Hello, hello.
How are you doing?
I'm all right, how are you?
I'm not too bad.
How you been getting on?
Busy. Sort of sorting your showroom out and getting things organised.
So, Maria, how you been getting on?
Great, super.
Is that dog, as in your sales, on the lead or off?
He's still on the lead, I'm still controlling him, getting there.
Hello, about you, Kerry?
I've had a very good week.
Why, what's going on?
Well, I've got some orders. I've sold some furniture and I've sold some curtains.
Bloody hell, that would sell. It's amazing. So do you feel different about the way you sell?
Yeah, definitely, because as soon as the customer approaches me, I'm fully aware of that barrier between us. Oh. And I'm walking away from the stands instead of walking between them.
Well, that's an achievement. The one thing you've said, though, is your showroom, so let's go and have a look.
Will Ruth see the streamlined sales floor she wants?
Right, we've worked really hard. Heated discussions later. What do you think?
I could see exactly what you've done. And this area here is great. But I would still say...
No.
It's still a little bit too cluttered here, just a little bit. But I think just with a few tweaks, it would make it so much better.
I'm going to argue with that loudly.
Well, you can. I mean, to be fair, Tina, we've got that much to get on with.
I know.
We can stand up here and argue all day. Yeah. Out of the whole display, what's the one thing you want to smack in your face? Okay. Your curtains. Because that's what you're here for. The biggest thing for me, though, is I want to see them. I don't want them to be hidden. I actually want to touch those curtains because I'm a buyer and I've got to get this close and there's no room to actually go, oh, look, you've decluttered, I'd say, 80% and it just needs a little bit more.
I'm not going to go there.
Right, all right. Well, do you know what? I will be honest, Tina, you're going to have a right battle with me this 2 days, so this is like the tip of the iceberg.
While Tina licks her wounds, Ruth takes the opportunity to have a quiet word with Marie.
Right, Marie. I've asked you in here so we've got a bit of privacy.
Okay.
Tell me what's been going on while I've been away.
A lot, really. With the showroom, there's been a bit of arguments and discussions about the showroom.
Do you think it's because nobody challenges her in the business and she's not used to it?
Definitely, yeah. Definitely. It's, as I've always said, it's a baby. She started it and, in a way, she'll finish it, I suppose.
But that's not good?
No, that's not good, but she does cling a lot.
Is she giving you responsibility?
Me, not yet.
Let's talk about you as in your sales. How have you felt?
I felt a lot more confident. I've took on your advice and I'm taking them to the curtains, I'm sitting them down, I'm telling them about my experience, how long I've been here and going through that process and telling a story, really, within the sale.
Yeah, qualifying what you're doing.
Yeah, and it's working.
I'm really pleased with your progress. What I don't want you to do is I don't want your head to drop. I'll sort your mum out, all right?
Yeah.
I'll leave you to get on with your job.
Thank you.
But before she can deal with control freak Tina, there's a very important visitor to prepare for. Inside Right, the interior design company Ruth and Tina pitched to are making a site visit.
Get all three benches working, get some buzz about the place and actually sit there and go for the clothes today. What can I do to get your business?
Yeah.
I really want to move quick on this because, as you can see, we're here, we're ready and we're waiting.
If Camberley impresses today, they could win a contract with the largest show home designers in the UK.
Hi, nice to see you again.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Hello,
Debbie. I'm Ruth Badger. Pleased to meet you.
Want to have a look at the workmanship of the...
The Badger's making sure Tina doesn't let this chance slip away.
Nice. Compares to what we're used to, doesn't it? It's stapled on, isn't it? So would you supply to us on Velcro?
If you need sort of Velcro, yeah, we can do that.
And would you hand stitch the Velcro on the back so it's not visible
at all? Yeah, it's not going to be seen, is it, from the front?
Okay. Do you cut the swags on the cross? Or
yes,
straight?
We do.
You do?
We think we get a better hang
of the drape.
Is that sort of the quality that you're looking for?
Yes.
Yeah,
definitely. Yeah.
Having come through a barrage of questions, Tina's on the brink of signing a deal.
We'll give you a manageable job, something that we feel you'll be able to achieve in the timescale.
Yep.
Get the work delivered back to us, we'll have a look at it, we'll get it hung, we'll get it inspected on site, and if we're happy with that, then obviously we'll just proceed forward and give you a go.
That's lovely. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Take care.
Have a safe journey.
Thank you.
Bye.
So what happened, Tina?
OK, it went swimmingly. They're going to give us a good order to begin with and see how we go, and I think it'll be very, very fruitful for us in the future. And, yes, we got it.
We're doing Robbie Williams.
Oh, am I the groom?
Yes. Well done.
Yeah, well done. Yeah. It just means that all three of these are going to be absolutely rammed.
OK, who wants overtime?
Me!
With contract work finally on the horizon, Camberley's turned the corner. It's the Badger's last day in the business, and she's got one final battle to fight with Tina over how she manages the team.
Tell me how the other staff have been doing.
It's been a struggle for Marie. We assumed that she could sell, and she can to a degree.
I've had conversations with Marie, and she's told me that her sales ability and patter is improved tenfold.
Right, I'd like to hear her say it to me, genuinely.
Right, so it's irrelevant whether she says it to me?
No. I'm not convinced of what you've just said.
But it's all about empowering people.
She was empowered and now she's not. That's as I feel it today.
Right, OK. The moment she's not in your shadow...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The moment that powerful figure's not looking over her shoulder, the big brother of the business, her confidence goes through the roof.
Marie's not empowered.
Do you know what's quite scary for me? And this is where I do get pissed off. They're moving on and you're not. You're still in the space that you were when I...
That's a load of tosh.
So
you hear one thing yesterday when I announced.
Listen to what I'm telling you, because I will lose my temper with you. If you get this wrong, you've got a daughter that's out of work, you're out of work, your husband's out of work, and one of your friends that you've employed for years and years is out of work.
I will learn as I go, and I've got a building that's mine.
But you're not learning, and do you know why you're not?
I am. I've got a business here.
You're not learning.
That I can leave the
work here. You can carry on giving me that. You have got so many hours to listen. Because what you're not doing, and I could physically shake you, is you do not listen to anybody.
Don't know these people.
No, I don't, but I've got a snapshot.
You've been here for 3 days and you've got a snapshot.
No, I haven't been here for 3 days. I've been here for 8 days.
OK.
Right, 8 days. 8 days of sitting, listening, watching, observing, which is a damn sight more than you've done in the last year in this business.
Stop, I need 5 minutes.
I'm seething. Oh, I am. This business is not going to be in 5 years if she carries on like that.
So what's the next step?
To rip Ruth's head off.
Right.
I'm calmer.
Half an hour later and tempers have cooled.
That break do you some good?
Yes.
Right, let's start from the beginning then.
Okay.
Marie? Kerry and Kev,
yeah.
I feel they have taken a step forward. What I can't let happen for the sake of you or them is for you to pull them back.
Probably I butt in where my nose is not welcome with them and I'll take over. I do know that I've got to stand back.
But not so far that it's... I want you to work better than standing back. I want you to work on the business instead of so much running. And what I mean by that is, I want you to work in the business, but I don't want you to be the business.
At the beginning of the journey, you said to me that I was too controlling. Because Ruth Badger's here today, your personality doesn't just flick a switch and everything's perfect. I've got to work on what I am doing wrong or what I'm doing right. And yes, it'll be worked on and yes, it will be solved.
It's time for the Badger to leave the business and her hometown.
And I knew that was going to happen. Everybody come and grab a glass. Well, I want to raise two toasts. The first one is to Tina, the woman who ruled the world and now the woman who's going to listen to everybody in the world. And most importantly, to the success and the contracts of Camberley Curtains.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Cheers. thanks very much for the experience. I think, yes, you have moved us forward. I've listened to a lot of what you said and I've accepted a lot of what you said. Thank you very much for coming. But will you leave now?
See you later. I know a girl with a golden touch. See you later.
See you, Elizabeth.
See you later. Good luck. See you soon.
Despite the battles, Ruth is confident she's helped secure a bright future for this company.
For me, on a personal level, I've taken a huge European contract into a company who actually 14 months ago took a big step backwards. That is a result.
Four weeks later, and the Badger returns to Camberley to see how things have developed.
Hello, hello.
Hi, hello, how are you doing?
I'm all right, how are you?
Not too bad.
Well, you're smiling, which is a good thing.
It is, definitely.
Let's have sit down and have a chat.
Go on, then.
For me, the biggest thing, the contract with Inside Right.
We're doing a plot in Tamworth, really nice plot. By the sounds of it, should be sort of prestigious plot. And that should happen very, very shortly. And once we've got one, there's no doubt we'll get lots more.
And what's happening here? Have more customers been coming through the door?
Both you and I agree that it's a difficult plot to find. We're going to use it to do the contract work, but we've gone and we've had a shop.
You've got a shop? That is fantastic. You've got that frontage now, which is the most important. How are you? How have you changed?
Totally. I now know that my team are brilliant. Kerry now runs the downstairs. Marie's totally took over the shop for me. And I'm actually letting them. It has made a total difference to my life, not only business life, home life, the way I speak to people. I listen. For that alone, thank you.
Hello, hello.
Hiya.
Hello.
I hear that you've got new roles.
Yeah.
Have you actually got a bit of freedom now?
We've got lots of freedom and it's really weird.
So it's weird?
yeah, really.
But positive?
Strange. Positive.
Oh, yeah. It's great, yeah.
Yeah, you're enjoying it. Yeah. So how was the Ruth Badger experience for you two?
Out.
Seriously, no, how was it?
Very positive.
For me, that was an absolutely amazing result. Number one, what happened to Tina? It's almost as if the time I've been away, she's taken everything on board. The girls have got roles, they actually believe they can sell, they've got trade business and they've got a shop. That is a fantastic situation and I sincerely think that I actually got to that business just at the right time.